It's Field Trip Friday, and look how beautiful it is. The leaves change in colors. We don't get that down here in the Valley.
Seasons actually happen in Arizona.
Yes, they do.
This is proof, right? Our crew is in Williams this morning, and they are full speed ahead with winter vibes for your weekend, as we are almost at the weekend. Scott and April are at the Grand Canyon Railway. That is just an iconic spot, and it was the first time that Nate did not scream and recoil when he saw Santa Claus, so I have a very good memory about it. It was amazing. It was a miracle.
Well, a lot of miracles happen up here on the Polar Express, so I am not surprised.
Hey, speaking of Santa, I saw him on the golf course yesterday.
Did you
really? Yeah, I did. Yeah,
well,
I asked him for better scores, so we're going to talk to him later this morning.
Well, let's hope you're on the good list this year then, Passmore, and we'll hope you get that. Let's talk about...
And with neon lights and Christmas trees and Christmas music, it is so fun.
Plus, of course, you've got to come down here to the train station. You know, we talk a lot about the Polar Express, but year-round, they've got the Grand Canyon trip, which is really, I remember doing this trip as a little girl, and I don't think much has changed. It's still the same conductor, George.
Well, the cars might have changed since you took it. I don't know, because we've updated some of the cars.
Yeah.
But, this is our daily train to the Grand Canyon. It departs here at 8:30, and it runs every day except for Christmas Day. And it leaves here at 8:30, gets there at the Grand Canyon at 10:45, and then with the they get to explore the Grand Canyon for 3 hours, then we come back, and it's 2 hours and 15 minute train ride.
Wow, that is so fun. Would you prefer to do it right now or in the summertime, or do you have to experience both?
Summertime's pretty busy, but it gets kind of crowded up at the Grand Canyon.
Yeah.
So right now is probably a good time to come. And then the trees are changing color, some of the trees that you see up at the Grand Canyon.
Yeah,
and it's pretty neat scenery on the way up there.
Yeah, it kind of takes you through that high desert of northern Arizona, and then you get in and you see a little fall color too. So.
Yeah, there's a little change of the topography.
Uh-huh.
You got the pine trees and the high desert, then you go back into the pine trees. Uh-huh.
So, George, you're the conductor. You're basically running the show. Who's driving this darn thing?
Well, the engineer runs the engine, but I'm kind of the manager. I'm responsible for the whole train. Yes, I am.
Uh-huh. All right. How long have you been doing this?
What
do you love about your job?
I've been working here for 5 years, and I love this job because I get some good people to work with, and I get to meet people from all over the world, all over the country, and get to help them make some great memories here on the Grand Canyon Railway.
One of the things that we do need to point out is that when you're on the train, you have to wear your mask, and that's a TSA thing, just like at the airports on an airplane,
right?
Yes,
it is. Yeah, that's the federal TSA mandate to wear the mask,
All right. What other kind of questions do people have for you?
Well, one of the big questions, how come you're not running the engine.
Right. Who's driving this?
Who's driving the train? But they ask a lot about the history of the cars, the engines, things like that.
Yeah. How fast does this go?
We go 40 miles an hour.
That's pretty fast.
Yes.
So you get to be on that train too, on the Polar Express. You get to go through that portal and everything.
Yes. Yeah. We'll be going through the magic tunnel on this train also.
So point out this is super cool over here. That's actually an original. They used to carry luggage on that, right?
Yes, those are the old luggage cars, and we still use it to put the luggage on it. Then a truck takes it up to the Grand Canyon.
Yeah.
So there's some entertainment that goes along with this, both before you board the train and then during the train ride. Can you talk about that?
Yes, down at the end of the depot down here, we have the Cataract Creek Gang does a little gunfight show. And then on the train, we have musicians that entertain you through the train ride. And then on the way back, there's a little thing that happens, a little train robbery that happens on the way back.
That's what I was referring to when I said it hasn't changed since I was a little girl.
Right.
Because I guess our train robbery wasn't the only time that this train has been robbed.
How old were you when you did that?
I want to say maybe 10, 12, I remember it vividly. And it must have been in fall because the pictures that we have, we're all in sweatshirts there on the rim of the Grand Canyon. And it was beautiful and, deer all around. And it is a great family memory and a really unique way, too, to see the Grand Canyon. I imagine a lot of people that come from all over the world to the Grand Canyon, this is a way that kind of brings them right through Williams.
Yes, it does. It starts out here in Williams. And then, you don't have to deal with the parking. You don't have to deal with any of that stuff.
Yeah.
So it's a great way to go to the Grand Canyon.
George, thank you so much. Always great talking to you.
Okay, Scott, thank you.
Really appreciate your time.
Thank
you. Are you the one that's...
Can we get an all aboard? Do you get to do that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Ready? Oh, clear the throat.
All aboard!
Well, that was pretty good.
That was good. You got us beat.
Nailed it.
We're very amateur at that.
I'm not even going to try to do it again. This is embarrassing.